Hello guys,
welcome to another edition of Subject Maths, and in today's class I'm going to be taking you through some past questions on nuclear chemistry. So all questions I'm going to be treating today is going to be on nuclear chemistry. So I want to say this, that try and subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you enjoy more video, more tutorials in chemistry class. So let's move on. The number one question says that which of the following is used to study arrangement of particles in crystal lattice? Now, we have four options here, and this question is JAMB question 2012, question 12. So, we ask that which of these is used to study the arrangement of particles in crystal lattice. If you watch the video on nuclear chemistry, that's the tutorial, full tutorial on nuclear chemistry, you find that the correct option is S3. S3 is used, one of the characteristics of S3 or uses of S3 is to study arrangement of particle or crystal lattice. So our option for this question is S3. So if you go through the tutorial, you will see more uses of S3. Now question 2 says that deuterium plus tritium will give us this. That's helium, neutron, and energy. Now, the reaction above illustrates. Now, we are asked that the reaction above illustrates which of this one. Now, if you get it very well, this is an isotope of hydrogen. This is also an isotope of hydrogen. This is combining together to give us heavier, because this is heavier than any of these. So, and if you go through the definition of all this, you find that the best option for this is A. Nuclear fission is when two elements combine together to form heavier elements. So, our option for this is A. So that's it. So, let's go to question 3. Question 3 says, balance the nuclear equation below and hence identify Y. This is WAEC 1990 theory question. So that's why there's no option. This is a theory question for A. Now, how do you balance this? This is nuclear equation. Now, when you look at it, the mass number here is 238 and the mass number here is 244. So difference in the mass number is 4. Four. 238 minus this will give you 4. Now, difference in atomic number is what? 2. 92 minus this, so we have 2. So, definitely Y is 4, mass number of 4, atomic number of 2, and which is equivalent to helium. Helium is the element that has this. So, to balance this equation, just say 238 92 uranium will give us 234 90 thorium plus 4 2. So that's the correct answer for question 3. Now, question 4 says, when uranium is placed in a lead block and electromagnetic field is applied, radiation is emitted as illustrated below. This is why question 1991, question 36. Now, this is the diagram we need to concern ourselves with. This uranium, this is a lead block, and this is electromagnetic field. And this is negative side, and this is positive side. So we have radiations. So now we are asked to find which radiation is represented as P. Now, if you go through my lecture on nuclear chemistry, you find that and under the principle charges attract, and that's how you play. Now, unlike charges attract. Now, you find out that the best answer to this is the alpha particle. Alpha particle are positively charged. So therefore, they are deflected toward the negative direction of electromagnetic field. So the best answer here is the alpha particle.
Now, question
5 says, radon is used as a tracer in medical research because, now remember, radon is what? Is a radioactive element. So have that in mind, that radon is a radioactive element. So it's used as a tracer in research because why? Because it's a radioactive element. That's the simple reason. It is used as a tracer, and this is one of the characteristics of a radioactive element. So you need to get what we do on nuclear chemistry tutorial so you understand that the radioactive element, these are one of the characteristics of radioactive elements. So they are used as a tracer in medical research. So that radium is used as a tracer in medical element because it's a radioactive element. So that's the matter. Now, question 6 says that a nucleus emits a beta particle. This beta particle. This is a beta particle. In the process of the anode atomic number. Okay, now we are told that if a nucleus emits a beta particle, so what are these options that is correct about that nucleus? Will the atomic number increase by 1 while the mass number remains constant? Will atomic number decrease by 2 while the mass number remain constant? Will the atomic number remain constant while the mass number decrease by 2? Or will the atomic number remain constant while the mass number increase by 1? So now let's do this. Let's assume that the nucleus of that radioactive element is X. Let's assume it's X. Now, when a radioactive element emits a beta particle, let's assume the period element, and then this is a beta particle. Now, let's assume the mass number of this element is N and Y. Now, when a radioactive element emits a beta particle, now the mass number remains the same, but this will be N. Because 0 plus N will give us N. Now, the mass number here is minus 1. So, what should be here should be Y plus 1. Because this minus 1 will cancel minus 1, so this one will give us Y. So, when a radioactive element emits a beta particle, the atomic number increases by 1. Will our atomic number increase? No. There's no increase in our atomic number. This is our atomic number, this mass number. So, when a radioactive element emits a beta particle, the option 1 said atomic number increased by 1 while the mass number remains constant. This should be our option because here our mass number is constant. 0 plus n will give us n. So, that means this new nuclei that is formed, the mass number is n. So, it's constant. But look at this, the atomic number increased by 1 because to balance this out, this minus 1 will cancel this. So, by the time you have this together, Y plus 1 minus 1 will give us Y. So, the parent element, so this one will give you the parent element. Do you understand? So, now, our mass number of this new element that will form from the nucleus of this parent element is going to increase by 1. I hope you understand that. So, a nucleus emits a beta particle. In the process, the atomic number increases by 1, while the mass number remains constant. So, your best option is A. I hope you understand that. And for better explanation, you can watch the video tutorial on nuclear chemistry. Now, question 8 says, what are the value of X and Y in the following equations? Now, this is the equation thorium. The nucleus of thorium disintegrate to a nucleus and a beta particle. Let me say nucleus of thorium emits a beta particle. This question looks like question 7. So we are asked that what is the value of X and Y? Now let's say 2 34 90. Now give us x, y plus the vector particle is this. Now just like what we are saying, this should give us 91, because 91 minus 1 give us 90, so x should be 91. So any option that has 91. Now the mass number remains the same, because 0 plus 234 give us 32. Y should be 234. So our x and y, so our best option is A. I hope you understand that. So now question 9 says this form this. X in the equation above represents. What is our X? What does it represent? This is heavy carbon or isotopes of carbon. So now let's say the same thing, just like what we did here. This is the same thing as. Now this and this, so we must have 7 here. So 7 minus 1 plus 7 give us this. Now our mass number of course remain 14, because 0 plus 14 give us 14. So that means the best option here is option C. I hope you understand that it's as simple as ABC. Now question 10 says define nuclear fission, and then a certain natural decay series starts with uranium, with U, that's uranium, starts with uranium and end with thorium. Each step involves the loss of alpha and or a beta particle. Using the given information, deduce how many alpha and beta particles were emitted. This is June 12, question 3A. Now let's go. Now number one, nuclear fission, just disintegration of a radioactive element into two equal parts of nearly equal mass. That when a radioactive element divide into two nuclei, that's one nuclei divide into two nuclei of nearly equal mass, and the release of energy and radiation. So that's simple definition of nuclear fission. It involves a bigger nucleus disintegrating to two smaller nucleus of nearly equal mass, and this process is accomplished by release of energy and radiation. Now let's treat this one. Now if a uranium disintegrates and is equal to a thorium, and uranium is 238 uranium, and atomic number is 92. I hope you understand that for the process. Hope you are with me. And then thorium 230 and atomic number of 90. Now of course we have a alpha particle and a beta particle. Alpha particle is in form of helium, so which has 4, and also our beta particle is in this 4. Now by the time we add this together, no, we need to balance it up to get this. We want to see how the reaction really took place. So now let's start with our atomic number. So this plus this will give us 1. 1 plus this, that's 91. So we didn't balance this up. So for us to balance this up, then let's assume that if our atomic number is 2, let's assume that our atomic number is 2. That means we have 2. Okay, let's just do this. We have 2 here. These 2 cover off for these 2. So then 2 times 2, that's 4. So our atomic number is 4. This plus 4 give us 1. That means this one 2 has to be 2. So once we balance our atomic number, I believe our mass number also will balance. So this is 2. That means this is 2 times 2 give us minus 2. So we have minus 2. 2 times this will give us 4. So 4 plus minus 2 will give us 2. So 2 plus 90 we add all this one together, then to give us 92. That means this is balanced. Now, 0, 2 times 0 is 0. 2 times 4 is 8. 230. So, 8 plus 230 will give us 238. So, that means our perfect equation is, let me write it out, is 238.92 of uranium, forming thorium of 230, atomic number of 90, plus 2 of helium, plus 2 of beta particle. So the question says, using the new information, deduce how many alpha and beta particles are emitted. So we have 2 alpha particle and 2 beta particle. These 2 alpha particle, these 2 beta particle. So all this combined for the process. I hope you understand this. So with this, I believe we come to the end of nuclear chemistry. You can go and also watch past lesson on nuclear chemistry, but half-life calculation. Go and watch the video of nuclear chemistry past question analysis by Jam and Echo, but mainly on half-life calculation. So thank you for being part of this class, and I hope you subscribe to our YouTube channel in order to enjoy more videos. You can also visit our website to see, be able to different, to be able to access more videos, physics, chemistry, math, and all that. But this is our chemistry class. I hope you enjoyed today's class. Thank you. Bye.